This is how much God loved the world. He gave his son, his one and only son. And this is why, so that no one need be destroyed. By believing in him, anyone can have a whole and lasting life. Father, this morning we just come into your awesome and most beautiful presence, Lord. So privileged, Lord, that by your blood, Jesus, we can enter into your courts with thanksgiving and praise. Thank you that you welcome us with a love that is overwhelming, extravagant, and so intimate. This one morning, Lord, we just want to love on you. We want to just love you with all our hearts, with all our minds, with all our bodies, with all that we are and all that we do. And we want to just receive your love afresh, Lord, anew. We want to encounter it in a way we've never encountered your love before. Come, Holy Spirit, fill and flood this place. In your precious name we thank you and pray. Amen.
Thank you. And come Holy Spirit and settle our spirits, Lord. Watch any distraction, even as we've sung, Lord. Just deal with attitudes and motives for worship, Lord. Ways in which we've made it about ourselves and not about you. We thank you for your presence here now, Lord, and we want to just open ourselves up, Lord, to all that you have for us, all that you want to do. More of you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you. just thank you so much, Lord, that your love is so relentless, that you're always on hot pursuit of us, Lord. We thank you that you are a God who interrupts our lives only in order to bring us back to the course that you want us to be on, the path that brings us life and life in abundance, Lord. And so even as just Moses stopped and turned when he saw the bush on fire, Lord, we just pray that you would continue, Lord, to interrupt our lives so we may stop and turn, be present to you, focus on you, so we can just move, Lord, into the places that you want us to move into, because we know that those are the places in which we will find and receive and live an abundant life, Lord. Help us be more attentive to your presence, we pray, Lord, in your precious name, Jesus.
what a huge relief it is that we don't have to be perfect as we come into your presence. Lord, you meet each one of us where we are at any given moment. Lord, whether we are feeling low, whether we are feeling confident or strong, you are there and you reach out to us. And you never, ever, ever leave us. You are attentive to each moment of our lives, Father. And so today we thank you for being our Father, for being our brother, for being our friend, to being anything that we need at any time of our lives. And above all, thank you for being our Savior. We pray this in your name, Jesus. Amen.
But now this is what the Lord says, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you, I have summoned you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flame will not set you ablaze. And later on He said that you are precious and honored in my sight. I love you. You called by my name, created for my glory, the one whom I formed and made.
Right for me, not just a spark.
to stay in this place of being aware. Of the amazing, indescribable, unconditional, extravagant love for us. The God who gave himself completely, without holding back. No reservation, no condition. Remember Jesus who poured himself out completely in the incarnation, in the crucifixion. And even now is there for us completely. This morning as we take part in the communion, want to receive afresh this incredible love for us. Not just to experience, but to allow it to flow through us. From the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread and broke it and gave it to the disciples saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Later he took the cup and said, "This cup is the blood of the new covenant that I make with you and with many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." We eat and drink gratitude with a sense of awe. The God who allowed himself to be crushed to pieces that he might give himself completely to us. As we eat and drink, Holy Spirit, we say, pour the Father's love afresh into our hearts. In Jesus' name. Amen.
you, Lord, for every healing that has happened, Lord, in this room, for every heart that has been touched and changed and transformed, for every body, mind, and spirit that has been stayed on you this morning. For your love, Lord, that truly is a miracle to us. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
So we've got 10 minutes for praise reports. Who would like to come and share? Anything to share? See, one thing we'd like to ask is if there was any, last week of course we did the session on healing and there were many words of knowledge and almost every word was responded to, I know. Did anybody get healed? Did anybody feel better? You can come and share, of course. Come and share.
Word about digestion, and I was having digestion problems, and it's gone. Thank you, Jesus.
Just want to continue from last week, and as Uday says, I had more prayer requests when I was giving thanks last week, and so many complications all got done. Uday says, I make accounting sound like one big adventure, but anyway. God was just gracious and so many things fell in place. I just wanted to share just now when we were singing this song before last and when Uday prayed, and I feel God's presence often here. I just want to share that I could just really feel God's presence in my heart just as he prayed that as he was doing the communion. So just want to thank God.
I was like, no, day before I was super stressed about exams and stuff, and you can ask Vinay, he was just like, it was Vinay's birthday and he was like, you want me to buy you a massage? So I was super stressed and anxious and stuff like that, and then like me and Mama prayed and stuff and we gave it to God, but like I was reminded of one thing is Jesus says about, you know, that he's watching over, he watches the sparrow and he's taking care of you. Something like that, right? That I don't need to worry, and just knowing that and knowing that your life's in God's hands and that, you know, I can chill. And after that, I've been super peaceful, so thank you, Jesus.
So I prayed for my back, I didn't get better. This is a Viraj style of praise report. But I did go on Monday to a spine specialist, and he did say that looking at my MRIs, which were 6 months apart, that there was a significant improvement actually in the MRI. So it's mainly because I've not bothered very much, have not taken much care, but that is dragging on, but it's much better. And you know, when I think of how much I've been able to do in this past year having this problem, I think that it's God's doing. Yeah. Sorry?
Everybody sort of
knows. I don't know, what is it?
On the off chance you did not check your messages yesterday, I had to go down to, I had to get a new passport recently, and I had to go down to the foreigners registration office because I have a US passport, but I also have what used to be the PIO card, person of Indian origin card. And then at some point they combined that with the OCI, which is overseas citizen of India. And I had been told when I got this in, I think 2004, that it's for life, but every 15 years you have to renew it, or every time your passport expires. So I had had my passport stolen at Old Delhi Railway Station in 2009, big drama. So I had to get a new passport. Anyway, I got my new US passport and I went down, and those people can be really, really nasty. I mean, I've seen them shout at people. So every time I go in, my knees are knocking and it's quite, you know, stressful. But I was at peace and I just went down and I went in, I waited about half an hour. I was the third person. I went in and I said, I just need to know what I need to do because I have a new US passport. He said, when did you get it? I said, 2 weeks ago. And I said, what do I need to do about my OCI card? And he just looked at me, goes, nothing. I was like, what? Nearly hugged him. I refrained. So basically what he said was, you don't have to do anything. It's for life. You just have to carry your old passport, your new passport, and this card, my PIO, OCI card. And there's many, many, you know, Vinod had said yes, and somebody else had said that. And then I checked several websites, and everybody said something different. And you know, our HR person said, you have to go and go through the whole process and renew it. And anyway, I was in and out in 2 minutes. And I just want to say thank you, Jesus, for making that such a stress-free process. And now I know what I'm supposed to be doing. So fantastic. Thank you, Jesus.
So you see the wisdom of what Jesus says, no, do not worry about tomorrow. We all get stressed before it happens only.
And I'm just giving thanks for God giving my mother another year of, I mean, looking after her so wonderfully, 98 years. And on the 3rd of October is her birthday. And God just, you know, what I'm just saying is, how wonderful and great and high and deep and wide and extravagant is God's love. Every day of our lives, every year of our lives, even when we're all gray and maybe our hearing is gone or almost gone, our memory is fading, He gave her 3 wonderful days of being loved. Being loved by family, her sons came down, being loved by her friends who she's known for 30, 40 years through her Bible study, in her Bible study group, being loved by, as she told somebody, all my young friends at Thursday Bible study and all her newer friends at Hindi Bible study. It was just non-stop. Somebody said, celebration is Thanksgiving. It's just non-stop giving thanks to God for all His wonder and all His beauty and all His love. And just say thank God for those wonderful days. She couldn't quite remember whether it was her birthday the day before, the day after, or whether it was her birthday that day. But she just knew how loved she was. And that is God.
On Tuesday, Anne Miss had organized a trek, so we all got to go to Sanjay Gandhi National Park. And while we were there, we got like a small time of being able to worship. So that was the first time for me where I've been able to do it in this community of being outdoors and hearing the waterfall and just being in such a beautiful space. And so enjoy throughout of being able to marvel at His creation. When we're singing it, we're seeing it, you know. And it was so special, so sweet. And throughout this week, I've missed so many things that have happened here, but being able to have that has kind of kept me going throughout this week. So just want to praise God for giving us that time together, and thank you, Ambis, for organizing that.
Lord, we just don't want to sing of what you're doing, Lord, or stirred by what we've seen today, Lord. But even what you've sown in us today, Lord, let it bear fruit. Let it bear the harvest of us stepping out, Lord. As you lead us, as you call us out, Lord. As we've heard today, Lord, we are your church, and Lord, we want to be your church in every way, Lord. To reflect you, to represent you, to be your hands and feet and mouth, Lord, to this world. Lord, we live in exciting times, Lord. You're on the move in our midst, around this city and world, Lord, and we want to be part of that, Lord. The Holy Spirit, equip us afresh. Give us your boldness. Give us a passion, Lord, to see your kingdom come. We give you thanks and praise for today. All that you have done in our midst. In Jesus' name. Amen.